Okay guys, I will give you the solutions of your homework, and then if you have another answer not the same with me, you can ask me directly and we will discuss it together. Okay, number 1A, expand each of the following. So I taught you only 1A, yeah. So 1 minus 2x to the power of 4 means 4c0, and then plus 4c1 plus 4c2 plus 4c3 and then plus 4c4. Okay. And then 1 1 1 1 and 1. Actually, for the 1, you didn't have to calculate it, because 1 to the power of anything, it will give you the same answer, which is 1, yeah. So you only write the negative 2x, and then negative 2x, and then negative 2x. Okay, the powers is the same with this one, 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, let's calculate this using calculator. And the result is like this, 1, minus 8, 24, negative 32, and 16, yeah. So this is the answer for number 1A. Next is number 2. Show that 1 plus square root of 5 minus 1 minus square root of 5 equals to that one. Hence, deduce the values of 1 plus square root of 2 to the power of 5 and blah blah blah. Okay, let's try to show this one first. Okay, so I have to expand 1 plus square root of x to the power of 5, yeah. It will be 5c0 and then 5c1. 5c2, 5c3, 5c4, and then 5c5. Okay, 1 doesn't need to be written because the answer is always 1. So I will write the square root of x only like this. Okay, this is to the power of 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The result will be 1 plus 5 square root of x plus 10x plus 10 square root of x cubed, right, plus 5x square plus square root of x5. Okay, this is for 1 plus square root of x. How about 1 minus square root of x to the power of 5? The result will be the same because the number is the same, but the difference is the first one is plus, the second one is negative. Cuman di sini aja perbedaannya. 1 minus, kalau yang negatif itu selang-seling ya. Plus again, and then negative. Okay, good. The question want us to subtract it, so we have to subtract the first one with the second one. Subtract it, this one become 0, this one is 0, this one also 0. So the answer will be minus minus, so plus 10 square root of x minus minus 20 square root of x cube, and then this one is positive 2 square root of 5 x5. Okay, for this one we cannot simplify it, so we will leave it like this. For this one we can keluarin x-nya ya, jadi x square root of x, okay, and then plus 2x square root of x. Okay, so we already show that the subtraction of this and this, yeah, is the same with our answer, and then hence deduce the values of this and this. Okay, so what is the similarity between the first expression and the question of the numbers, yeah? So 1 plus square root of 2, 1 minus square root of 2, that means the x is 2, the x is 2, right? So to find the result, we only change the x into 2. So I can tell that 1 plus square root of 2 5 minus 1 minus square root of 2 5 will be the same with our answer before, but for the x we have to change it into 2. Okay, let's change the x into 2 equals to 10. The square root of 2 plus 20 times 2 times square root of 2 plus 2 times 2 square root of 2. The result is 10 square root of 2 plus 40 times square root of 2 plus 8 times square root of 2. The result is 82.02, or maybe in exact answer it will be 58 square root of 2. Okay, that is for number 2. Next is number 3. Number 3, the question only want us to find the first 4 terms in ascending powers of x, yeah. So 3g, 1 plus 2x to the power of 9. We will prepare it first. 9c0, 9c1, 9c2, 9c3, yeah. 4 terms, okay. For the 1, I will not write it. Okay, this one is 0, 1, 2, 3. And then we will use your calculator to calculate this. Okay, this is the answer for number 3D. Next is 3G. 3G is the same, yeah. 1 minus 2x squared to the power of 7. 7, right? Okay. So 7C0, 7C1, 7C2, and 7C3. This one is negative 2x squared to the power of 0, negative 2x squared to the power of 1, negative 2x squared to the power of 2, negative 2x squared to the power of 3. This is your calculator, and the result will be, okay, this is the answer for 3G, yeah. 1 minus 14 plus 84, negative 280, and so on. Because the question only wants us to find until 4 terms, we only answer like this, yeah. Okay, next is this one. We have to multiply 1 minus 6x to the power of 4 and 1 plus 2x to the power of 7. This will be take a long time and take a lot of effort. So 1 minus 6x to the power of 4, we will prepare it until x to the power of 3, yeah, because the question want us to find the result including x to the power of 3. So we will expand each of them until x to the power of 3. That means I will have 4c0, and then 4c1, and then 4c2, and then 4c3. 1 doesn't need to be written like this. Okay, 0, 1, 2, 3. I will calculate this first, and the result is like this: 1, negative 4, 216, and negative 8. 64x to the power of cube, yeah. The biggest is cube. Next is 1 plus 2x to the power of 7. This one also the same. For 7c0, 7c1, 7c2, and then 7c3, and then 2x to the power of 0, 2x to the power of 1, 2x to the power of 2, and 2x to the power of 3. I will calculate this first. Okay, so this is for the second one. Now we have to multiply it one by one until we get the terms including ascending powers of x up to including x cube. Okay, so I will have 1 minus 24x plus, let's write it completely, yeah. So first is 1 minus 6x to the power of 4 times 1 plus 2x to the power of 7 equals to 1 minus 24x plus 216x squared, and then negative 864x cubed plus blah blah blah, times it with the result of the power 7. 1 plus 14x plus 84x squared plus 280 x cube plus blah blah blah. Okay, let's multiply it one by one. The first one is this, 1 times 1 equals to 1, and then 1 times 14x equals to 14x, and then this one plus 84x squared, and then the last one plus 280x cubed, yeah. Okay. And this one negative 24x, and then this one berapa tuh? Negative 336x squared, and then the last one is negative 24 times 84, negative 2016x cubed, ya. Yeah. For this one doesn't need, because the powers is 4. The question only want us to find until x cube, yeah. So the next will be this one, positive 216 x square, and then this one 216 times 14 plus 3024 x square, x cube. And then udah nggak bisa lagi ya, udah. Terakhir yang ini, negatif 864x cube, dah. Tinggal di simplify, and then ini 1, 14 sama negatif 24, dah. Ininya negatif 10x. And then x square 84 minus 336 plus 216 negative 36 x square, and then the cube 280 minus 2016 plus 3024 minus 864 minus 864. It's 424x cube. Okay, the answer is correct. It's the same with the answer key. Let's go to the next questions. Number 10. In each of the following expansions, find the indicated term, the fifth term, yeah. So the first one, A, is 1 plus 4x to the power of 7. The fifth term will be 7c4. Remember, when the question want us to find the n term, the n should be minus 1. Okay, so 7c4 times 1 to the power of to the power of 4, and the 1 is the rest, 7 and 4, the rest is 3, yeah. So 7c4 times 4 to the power of 4 equals to 8960x4. There you go. That is the fifth term. And then for the C, 1 minus 2x to the power of 10, the middle term. This one is a little bit tricky. The middle term will be the... Okay, let's try this. If the powers is 10, so we will have 11 terms, right? That is the pattern, like the video. Okay, 11 terms, so we will have 11 terms. The middle one will be, so we will split the 11 terms into 5 terms, the first 5 terms, and the last 5 terms is already 10, yeah. So the middle one will be the 6th term, right? The 6th term. Okay, or you can use this one also, 11 plus 1 divided by 2. To find the middle term is 11 plus 1 divided by 2 is the 6th term. So we will have to find the 6th term. The 6th term means you write 10c5. Yeah, 10c5, 1, and then negative 2x to the power of 5, this one also 5. Use your calculator, times negative 2 to the power of 5, negative 8064 x to the power of 5. There you go. Okay, next is the next page, ya. Expand the following. 3 minus 2x to the power of 4, that means 4c0, and then 4c1, and then 4c2, 4c3, and last one is 4c4, ya. Okay, next is 3, and then 3, and then negative 2x, negative 2x, negative 2x, negative 2x, and then negative 2x. Okay, good. Next is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Terus 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. The result will be... Okay, and the result is like this. Yeah, it's for number A. Next, number 2A, 2 plus 3x to the power of 6 for the first 4 terms, yeah, so 6c0, and then 6c1, 6c2, and then 6c3, 2, 2, 2, 2, 3x, 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 and then 3x, and then blah 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 blah. Okay, so this one is 0, 1, 2, 3, 6, 5, 4, 3. The result is like this. Okay, that is for 2A. Next. Okay, number 3. Obtain in ascending power of x the first 4 terms. Yeah, the first 4 terms for 2 minus x over 2 to the power of 7. 4 terms. 7c0, 7c1, 7c2, 7c3, ya. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. 2, negative x over 2. 2, negative x over 2. 2, negative x over 2. And then 2, negative x over 2. And then blah, 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 blah. Then equals to. Oh wait, not yet, ya. This one is 0, 1, 2, 3. This one is 7, 6, 5, 4. Okay, the result is... Okay, this is the result of our expansion, the four first term, ya. 128, negative 224x, plus 168x squared, minus 70x cubed. And then hence, find the value of 1.995 to the power of 7, correct to 4 decimal place. What is the relationship between the first questions and the second questions? The second questions wants us to find 1.995 to the power of 7 equals to how much, gitu, yeah. So what is the relation between this and this? Take a look at 1.995. It's very close with 2, right? Is only 0.005 difference. So we can use this expansion to calculate this. Yeah. So we change this one into 2 minus something over 2 to the power of 7. Okay. Let's find the x first. Okay. So 2 minus x over 2 equals to 1.995. 2, sorry. Negative x over 2 equals to 1.995 minus 2. Negative x over 2 equals to 0.005. So negative x equals to, sorry, this one is negative, 0.01. So x will be 0.01, yeah. So we already get the x, so I can change this one into 0.01. And the expansion will be the same as our result before. So the expansion will be 128 minus 224x plus 168x squared negative 70x cubed plus blah 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 blah, because we use the expansion of 2 minus x over 2 to the power of 7. But for this time, we can change the x into 0.01. 128 minus 224 times 0.01 plus 168 0.01 square minus 70 0.01 to the power of cube, and so on, and then you will get the answers. From this expansion, I want to know, can you give me an explanation why we didn't have to count these parts? Yeah, why the questions want us only to count until x cubed, or only for first term? Yeah, the fifth term, the sixth term, the seventh term, the eighth term doesn't need to be count to calculate 1.995. Can you give me the reason? Tell me in the meetings, ya. Okay, so use your calculator. You 125.7767 correct to 4 decimal place, ya. Okay, next. Number 4, find the non-zero values of a and b of the expansion this. Yeah, so we have to expand to x minus a first to the power of cube equals to 3c0, 3c1, 3c2, or maybe you remember the Pascal triangle for the 3, 1, 3, 3, 1, yeah, it will be more easier. So this one is 2x, and then a, 2x, 2x, and then a, 2x, a, 2x, and then a, yeah, this one to the power of 0, 1, 2, 3, 3, 2, 1, 0. The result will be 8x cubed plus 4 times 3, 12ax squared. And this one, 6a squared x. This one is 11a cubed. Okay. The question shows us that our result should be the same with the questions. Negative bx squared plus 3 over 2 bx minus a cubed. Okay. Oh, there is minus, yeah, sorry. Minus, 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 minus. So this one should be negative, and this one should be negative. Okay. Nah, after this we have to find the a and b, yeah. So I can tell that from this one, I can tell that negative 12a should be equals to negative b. So I can say b equals to 12a, and then after this I can use this one. So from this one I can tell that 6a square equals to 3 over 2b. I can change the b into 12a, 3 over 2 times 12a. Okay, and then calculate it. 6a square equals to 618a. 6a square minus 18a equals to 0. 6a factorize a minus 3 equals to 0. A equals to 0. A equals to 3. Says non-zero, yeah, non-zero values for a and b. So we take a equals to 3, b equals to 12 times 3, b equals to 36. There you go, a equals to 3 and b equals to 36. Okay, number 5, we have this 2 binomial to the power of 9 and 2 plus x to the power of 5. We have to expand it into the first three terms, 9c0 first, second, the third. Okay, 1 doesn't need to write, negative 2x, negative 2x. So this one will be 0, 1, and 2. The result is later, yeah. This one is 5c0, 5c1, and then 5c2, 2 times x, 2 times x, 2 times x. Good. 0, 1, 2, and then 5, 4, 3. Let's calculate this. Okay, so we already have the answers for 1 minus 2x to the power of 9 and 2 plus x to the power of 5. The question wants us to expand one more time the multiplication of 1 minus 2x to the power of 9 with 2 plus x to the power of 5. Okay, so I will rewrite the expansion first. The expansion is 1 minus 18x plus 144 x square plus blah 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 blah, and then 32 plus 80x plus 80x square plus blah 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 blah. The question want us to expand until x square, yeah. So this one can be calculated 32, and the second one also plus 80x, then the third one also can plus 80x square. Okay, this is for the red one, and then for the blue, negative 18 times 32 equals to 576x, and then this one negative 18 times 80x equals to negative 1440x square, and then we cannot do this one, yeah, because it's x cube. The last one is this one, 144 times 32 plus 4608x squared. We cannot do that one also. So this is the result. Next, simplify. 32 plus 80 minus 5676. Sorry, negative. Negative 496x. And then 80 minus 1440 plus 4608 plus 3248x squared. Okay, that is the answer. Okay, last one, number 6. The middle term of x plus 1 over 2x squared to the power of 12. The middle term, okay. To find the middle term, we have to find the number of term first. For the power of 12, we have 13 terms, yeah. 13 terms, that means if we want to find the middle term, 13 plus 1 over 2 equals to 7. So it will be the 7th term. The 7th term will be 12c6, okay, and then x, and then 1 over 2x squared to the power of 6. This one will be 12 minus 6. The rest, yeah. So use your calculator, you will get 12c6 times half to the power of 6 equals to 231 over 16 x6 over x12. So 231 over 16 x to the power of negative 6. Yep, it's with. Yeah, it's correct. Okay, guys, that is for your homework. I will continue our session. It will be the last session of this chapter. Please watch my next video, ya. Dadah, thank you.